Okay, welcome back to our channel. It has been a hot minute since we put out a video. So in this video, we're gonna do a bit of a catch up, how I did at the T100 Miami, and then everything that actually led me to get into that start line, overcoming the big injury that I had in Hawaii. And yeah, just catching up with you guys, giving you an insight into what we've been up to. So I guess we'll start with the journey to getting to Miami. It was never guaranteed that I would actually make the start line. I did have to have a big time off from running from the injury that I sustained in Hawaii. I think in total it was almost 16 weeks without running just to let that injury fully heal. So it was about mid-February by the time that I actually got to what I would say running, not walk running, actually doing run sessions. So I had a total of 6 weeks of running leading into the race in Miami. Some of that did have some intervals in it. We kind of set about 10 days out from the race. I did a test session where I kind of ran at my target pace for the race, got through that without any issues, and then we booked the flights and knew that I would actually be making the start line, and I was confident that my body could actually tolerate the load of the race and come away without making that injury that I'd had worse, make it come back. I knew that I was quite confident I could finish the race healthy and in one piece. I just wanted to be at the first race of the T100 series. I definitely didn't want to miss out on kicking off the season in March and yeah, just seeing where I was at against the other athletes.
Ranked number 4 in the PTO World Rankings, the current Ironman World Champion from Great Britain, Lucy Charles Barclay.
Going into this race, I didn't have like a clear game plan or any tactics for how I was gonna race. Ultimately, I wanted to stay with the front, whatever that may be. I didn't actually expect to be the front of the race, which I know sounds crazy because that's usually how I race. Given where I had been and going into this race, that was clear instructions from my coach that this was like almost a training exercise to gather the data from a race simulation and then we can build on it in training. So actually it definitely exceeded my expectations to be at the front, to be leading the race. And I remember being on the bike thinking, well, at least this is just great data to take into training when I go home. And maybe because I didn't feel much pressure because I was racing in that environment, I actually did race better than I did expect. It was always going to be early season. Not many athletes race in March. It's definitely early, especially coming from the UK where we definitely don't have warm weather like in Miami. So it was a good test to see where I stacked up. And I think most of the other athletes felt quite similar. It was going to be a test to see where the early season fitness was and where everyone else was stacking up, and everyone was up for racing that early. We definitely had some great performances. I think the Brits did show just how strong they can be. India had an amazing performance, which again I love to see. She was actually training at the same pool as me in Kona, so I saw her putting in the hard work there, and she definitely deserved that result. So I think she's got a really good start to the season, and I look forward to racing her throughout the series, but also the other athletes as well, seeing Holly Lawrence get back into some really good form early in the year. So I think this series is going to be super exciting, and each race I'm hoping will just get better and better. Over the moon to come away with second place. For the first race of the season, it definitely wasn't bad. I would say I felt quite flat on the swim. I did actually expect that it would be like the whole group with me when we kind of got to that Aussie exit. And that was quite a nice surprise that it was only Lucy Buckingham with me at that point. And it allowed me to kind of relax a little bit for that second part of the swim, knowing we had a bit of a gap on the other girls. I felt really confident on my bike, actually. I've done a little bit of outdoor riding, kind of technical skill riding on the Velo Park near me. So I felt like I was handling my bike really well, felt super confident in that aspect. But definitely the watts were quite low. I think my power was actually lower than I was riding in Kona. So there's definitely some improvement to be had there. The bike course in Miami was actually 22 laps. Going into the race, I was like, oh my God, like this is gonna be so long. It's gonna make 80 kilometers feel way longer than it is. And actually when I look back to when I raced in Miami in 2021, it was like more of a long Olympic distance than the T100 distance. Actually really surprised me how fun I found the bike course. And there was a big digital board that told us how many laps we had left to go. So I never at any point was counting laps. I was just doing my thing in the zone and then occasionally would look at the board and see how many laps I had left. Yes, it kind of got dark towards the end, which did add a different element into the race, but I was just happy that I'd gone for the clear visor, which meant that I could still see pretty well. I definitely think it looked worse on the coverage than what we was experiencing. It's just another element and another challenge being thrown into the race. It's probably one of the most fun I've had on the bike in any race that I've done. So surprisingly, yeah, 22 laps went super quick and was really enjoyable. Yeah, on the run, I definitely was running to what I'd said in training would be a safe pace for me to run at, not putting myself at any risk. And definitely was pleased with how my nutrition strategy had worked throughout the whole race. I made sure to get the electrolytes on board and get enough carbs in, so the overall energy level felt pretty good. And it was still very hot and humid on that run, so you had to make sure that you'd done your nutrition right throughout the race to make sure you got through it as best as possible. Whilst I didn't have like a clear position goal, I felt like the top five would be really, really good given where I was at in my training and off the back of quite a big time off. So that was kind of where I would have liked to be. So actually to come away with second definitely exceeded my expectations. And I think for the overall series takes a little bit of pressure off because I have got a good positional result. I've got good points from that race. And whilst I have to race six races for my contract, it's my top three results and the grand final that count towards my world ranking at the end of the year. So I definitely feel in quite a good position with that. It allows me to be a little bit more flexible now with if I want to add in some other races. It should just be a lot of fun. I think racing the same women is going to help me to kind of adjust my tactics slightly in the race, to see what I need to do to get the best out of myself. But overall, yeah, just again looking forward to this season, and it's nice to have a good result under my belt already. Yeah, gosh, 2021 Miami was definitely not one of my best races. It was off the back of a massive time off, obviously because of COVID, and I made a few silly mistakes in that race and still came away with second, but I did have a penalty and yeah, some other mishaps happened in that race. So this one definitely felt a lot better than that. I don't think I made any stupid mistakes. It's just early season, so I showed where my early season form is. Still the same result, coming away with a second, but overall I feel in a lot better place than I did in 2021, which was probably the best season I've had in the sport. So I feel like I'm in quite a good place to just build on this performance and yeah, hopefully go from strength to strength throughout the year. Singapore, again, it's going to be hot and humid. It will be hotter and more humid than Miami was. So I think, again, it was a good stepping stone going into this race. I really enjoyed the race in Singapore last year. So I think I know the course quite well. It's still fairly technical on the bike. So I think, again, we can build on this race and hopefully I can have a slightly better result. I was off the back of an injury in that race. Yeah, just looking forward to it. The crowds were amazing there. I love the city. So I have good feelings going back, but I'm definitely hungry for a better result than I had in August last year. Since the race in Miami, it barely feels like I've sat still. It's been so busy. I've had two photo shoots, some biomechanics testing, some wind tunnel testing, which I'm sure we'll share all of that with you in another video. But something cool that I actually got the opportunity to do, which I think I can share this with everyone, is that the Wings for Life run is coming up in May, early May. It's one of the biggest events that Red Bull do worldwide. And I'm going to be quite involved in, I guess, the app run of that race. So we'll put all the details below if you want to sign up. I haven't got any actual racing in May this year, so I should be able to physically take part in the Wings for Life, which I haven't done for a few years now. Yeah, we'll put all the details below. And yeah, if you do sign up for the app run, you may hear quite a lot of my voice during the run, which I guess is as much as I'll share for now. I got really lucky to be part of that, and it's such an amazing cause, an amazing event. So if you are free, I think it's on the 5th of May, then definitely look at the link below and sign up. Okay, thanks as always for watching this video. We are going to get videos out more regularly now. We have been super busy leading up to this point, so definitely make sure to hit that subscribe button, as we will have lots more videos coming out very soon. And as always, thanks for watching. Actually, it really surprised me how fun. Have you had enough? It actually was way more fun.